as the setting sun lies dying in the cradle of the west. Daylight scurries swiftly from the sky. There is nothing you've said or done to make me want to go, but the morning sun will see our last goodbye. Don't cry when you hear me say I'm leaving you.
No standing ovation.
Shut the fuck up!
Wow. How's it going, New York?
I love rock singers.
Wow.
Brooklyn!
I'm just going to say wow.
Brooklyn!
Wow.
Brooklyn!
Wow. It's cool to be in Brooklyn.
Lord have mercy on
Brooklyn. Wow, Brooklyn. Wow, it's great to be in Brooklyn. Let's see what else here. It's good to be here in Brooklyn. It's good to be here. Gowanus.
Yeah, you can fade the music out. There we go.
Thank you, ladies. Thank you very much. Thank you. Wow.
Boricua.
Holy shit.
We got the virus, and it's party time.
There you go. And let me welcome our viewers at home across the world. We are coming to you live from the Bell House right here.
My wife wants some
Matt
vegetables for crudité, right?
So what do you need? What can
are
I do you for?
Are we broadcasting live?
We're live on the internet.
No problem.
No problem. Wes, no problem.
We good?
Oh yeah, they love
Doug
it out there.
And Vic, let me just tell you something. You have a long. You have a long leash. You have a long leash today.
Oh, thank you.
I have nothing.
Thank you, Tim.
Thank you, Tim.
I have
Tim. Thank you, Tim.
people like Tim.
I love Roxy music.
Tim Apple.
I'm a serious guy.
Tim.
I love Roxy
there
music.
There is a leash, though, just so you know. I mean, they're...
Wow. Dumb.
The, my, I've got nothing to, I have nothing really to say. No preparation went into this for me.
Just what they want to hear. That's... wow.
The real show, of course, was last night and tonight. I'm just kidding. We're going to have a great show. We have a great show planned.
Mm-hmm.
And, Matt, let's see if everything works. Let's take a Zoomer. Let's see who's out there in the world. Who's out there? Who is out there?
Andy Mills.
Hello there.
Can I get a little more of me?
How are you?
Ian D. Ian D. Can you hear us there on Zoom? Can you unmute Ian D? He can't unmute.
All's well.
A what?
Eli. Eli, how about you? You got something for us tonight?
Okay.
Today?
What up, y'all? How's it going? Can you hear me?
There he is.
Nice.
Get off you!
Where are you?
I'm in
New York.
Woodland Hills, California.
Okay, coast to coast. Art Bell.
What?
George Norrie. Well, it's...
It's awesome to be live there with you, Tim. How's the tour been going? And any plans for a live record?
Yes. Well, we have been recording. Sorry, I'm just getting shocked off this microphone quite a bit. That's kind of fun, right?
Like Woodstock.
Like Woodstock. Well, we have been recording every show, and I think I want to just like Grateful Dead style and just put them all out, you know? Let you guys sort through.
Yes.
Maybe Vic's Picks.
Vic's Picks, yeah.
Vic's Picks Volume 4 coming to you live.
Cool. Well, their tour's been great. You guys all know that. I've been talking about it forever. These shows, have anybody been to one of these shows so far? Review? Positive? Positive reviews.
I'm a deadhead.
I came out the first night and... oh, he's a deadhead.
Wow!
I will get high.
Get back to work.
Bye, Eli. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Every night's been a little rough in different ways here. We're running, I mean, it's been good. I don't think anyone notices this stuff, but we notice it. We had guitar tech issues. My guitar was very out of tune the other night, and...
Oh.
I can't just be up here tuning my guitar, like, while you guys are watching. It's the worst. That's why I don't like the Grateful Dead. It's what they do for the first 30 minutes of their show. So...
just go ahead now.
All right, let's take another Zoomer while I think of something else to talk about.
All right, I think we have Sam.
Or Vic, how was your touring experience?
My
so
tour
far?
Has been the best. I've loved every minute of it. And
Vic made us get pierogies last night for dinner. And it was, I think we all suffered gastronomical
really,
experiences.
Really rough morning. You getting shocked again?
Matt, can I get somebody from the sound department to fix this? I'm getting shocked. It's ruining my experience. And then the audience is going to have a bad time. They're already having a bad time.
Can we swap it out for that one first real quick?
It might be me. I just have been so charged.
Mine was shocking too, so I'm just keeping my distance.
Well, you're just not grounded.
Wait, that I would be. Yes, I am grounded. That's how it goes.
I don't know.
Captain Scarlet, Captain Scarlet. Captain Scarlet, Captain Scarlet.
You hear this? Let's try this. We started this last week. We'll start doing an opening monologue. Do you hear this? Do you hear this? Fauci's finally retiring. Do you hear about this? Fauci, Anthony Fauci. It's definitely not the microphone because I'm the shocks are back. This Fauci's finally retiring. Do you hear about this?
Now I'm getting excited.
Yeah. I heard he's going to retire to a nice island where the perception is that he did everything right and everything worked out just fine. Yeah, it's called Fantasy Island. No more lockdown. That's all I got. Matt, do we announce who's our musical guest tonight?
Oh, we haven't yet. No, this is going to be fun. So we'll wait.
It's Bono! No, it's Roger Daltrey.
My wife!
Well, can I just...
My wife!
So let me... Can I take credit for that?
Yeah, of course. Yeah.
I play it again.
My wife!
I was, I wake up at fucking 7 in the morning for no reason, nothing to do. And I just start watching this. Why? Why do I watch The Who from 1973 in Philadelphia, their live set? No, audio only, nothing to watch. And it's kind of good, I'm kind of enjoying it. But then Roger Daltrey is introducing the new song from John Entwistle.
He's an old one from a geezer. Yeah, from a geezer, John Entwistle. It's called
My Wife.
And I go there. That's what I do for a living. I sent it right to Vic and said, Vic, we got something.
My wife.
I went fishing this morning. Got to get up early to catch the fish. Speaking of my hotel, anybody want to come by later tonight? We're gonna have a little party in my room. We're at a pretty nice hotel. And
I love Batman.
That played very well last week, that Batman clip. But you know the keys where you gotta swipe. You know the car keys. This thing is I have to reset it every night. Mm-hmm. Every night I gotta go down. And it's been a nightmare. They're so sensitive.
They don't apologize or anything. They just know what you're there for.
Yeah.
And they're like,
anybody want to guess? No, there's no way to guess what movies I've been watching at 3 in the afternoon.
Oh, yeah.
What do we guess what you're watching in the...
Yeah, what do you think my go-to watch in a hotel room is?
What time of the day? Did you say 3 in the afternoon?
I'll say like 2 in the afternoon.
Okay. I'll go Forensic Files. That's my preference.
No, I don't know. Well, you might know.
Probably Baseball.
Family Feud.
Seinfeld.
Oh, Seinfeld. Yeah. Okay.
Pretty good show.
It's cool. On the tour.
They run it like on the toilet?
No. On the tour, everyone was like, you look like Newman.
Hello, Newman.
That's a nice thing to say to somebody.
It's really nice. It's been helpful for my self-esteem. So.
Newman!
A famous actor. I look like a famous actor.
Hello, Newman.
How about when Newman's in Jurassic Park and it's all raining out and he's trying to get in there? Trying to get that secret DNA out of there.
It takes you right out of that movie. It's like, that's Newman. Yeah. You can't watch. I shut the movie out. I walked out. I can't finish it.
Watch up until
what happens in that movie?
Oh, I heard a good joke. Can I tell the joke I heard? Do you like the joke?
Yeah, sure.
This is also what I watch. As you know, I watch Johnny Carson. And I saw Johnny Carson interviewing Walter Matthau from the 1980s. And this is the joke Walter Matthau told. So there's these three old guys. And they're sitting around, very old, sickly old men. And the one old guy says, I would do anything to have a nice number one. You know? Just a nice number one. I go to the bathroom and it just trickles out and it hurts and it takes forever. And the other guy says, "Well, I would love." Thank you. That's what Doc Severinsen was doing. I would love to have a number two, a good number two. Every morning I get up and it's just I'm squeezing, and it's hurting and nothing's coming out and it's just pain. And the third guy.
Sure smells good.
The third guy says, oh, man, I have the best number one. I get up 7:30 in the morning, and it's like a fire hose. I mean, it is like the Mississippi River. It is a gusher. It is a beautiful 7:30 morning. Every morning, 7:30. And then 7:45, I have the perfect number two. I mean, it is like Mount St. Helens. Not that that would be a, yeah, huge, huge.
I can smell them.
Every morning, 7:45. And the guy goes, well, what's the problem? He says, well, I don't get out of bed till 9.
Pretty good.
Did you get that? Did you get it? She's, I see somebody in the front thinking about it.
Oh.
Doing the math. He shot the bed. Ooh. Well, and
boom.
And he pissed the bed, and he seems to do it every morning.
You know what's not bad? A fried egg sandwich.
All right, Matt, should we try another Zoomer? I know. Or should we do the city of the day? All right, Matt, give it to me. Who is the city of the day? What is the city of the day?
Well, as you know, first we would have our sponsor.
Oh, fuck. You think I'd have gotten some clue about how this show works by now.
But you could take a break this week, Tim.
Yeah.
Oh, yes. The city of the day is brought to you by...
Garden Rake with Handle.
All right. I think they sent us a video, didn't they, the sponsor?
Yeah, they...
Yeah, there you go. All right, let's see what they sent.
Does this ever happen to you?
Hey, have you seen my rake?
I don't know what you're talking about.
It's a stick with fingers on it that brings leaves.
I know what a rake is. Yeah, I don't... Why would you have... You don't have anything to rake.
Maybe I like to scrape stuff. I don't know. Who cares?
I don't know where the rake is.
I guess you don't know where anything is.
I know where everything is in this house that I work every day maintaining.
This table doesn't look that clean. Did you maintain that?
Is this one of your other little projects that you half complete and then abandon?
Like what?
Oh, I don't know, like your wiping stain?
That's my wiping stain. I'm gonna use that wiping stain.
That empty aquarium that you spent thousands of dollars on, bags of salt?
It's a saltwater aquarium and it needs salt.
It's been sitting over there empty for a year now.
We're in a drought.
Okay. Waiting for it to rain?
Yeah, I'm waiting for the rains.
It's been over there.
I can't do everything at once. I'm not everybody at all the time.
Yeah, I know that for sure.
I did that.
What even is that?
I put the rocks in there.
What is it for? What do you do with that?
What is it for? Look how people like it.
I've never heard anyone comment on it.
Sally liked it.
Sally's an idiot.
Then don't ever lose your rake again, cause Garden Rake with Handle is a good rake.
Garden Rake with Handle, now in green. Just $5.99 at Dollar Dream.
It's a good rake.
They made me act in their commercial.
What's that?
We gave them a... They made me act in their commercial. What?
Oh, here's... What is City of the... This city is our City of the Day guy. Alex, what are you at, work?
Doug, we'll talk about that privately.
Yeah, okay.
Hi, can you hear me okay?
Yeah.
I'm in class right now.
You're in class?
Yeah, it hasn't started yet, but I'm here.
Can you turn your camera around so we can see get a lay of the land in there?
Oh yeah, look at that.
Oh,
it's a very spacious room. Yeah, there's a lot going on.
Cool. What do you study? What's the class?
This is political theory. So very, very fun, exciting stuff. My professor's great. I was just talking to him. He's teaching another course, politics of the environment. I'm really looking forward to that. Yeah. Sorry about that. I'm kind of a nerd. Tim, you're on.
Okay, well, where are you? You're just here for the city of the day, not your syllabus.
Sorry, I don't mean to give you guys a
I'm monologue. Not getting an update on your syllabus.
I am in Richmond, Virginia. Oh, wow. Thank you guys so much. Really appreciate it.
All right, the city of the day is Richmond, Virginia. Thank you so much.
Yeah.
What's your GPA?
We don't need to get into that right now.
Look at that Yankees hat you got on, though, huh?
Yeah.
Let's go, Yankees.
We don't like this set. We just swept them the other day.
How about when you meet those Dodgers in the World Series? That ain't going to be pretty, is it?
No. We might have to have a talk after that series.
Yeah. All right, well.
Have a good show.
Thank you.
I don't take up too much time. Thank you for having me.
That was something.
I suppose we could ask the audience if they have any questions. Is that possible? Is that something we could do?
Sure.
It's part of the procedures here. That's probably why. Anybody want to chime in with a complaint?
Dang darn.
Any complaints?
This is woke bullshit right here.
What?
This is woke bullshit.
Whoa, what the
heck? Open your eyes, sheeple. Open your eyes.
What? I'm sorry.
This is George Soros funded woke.
Can we bring the house lights up?
Shit.
What's going
right
on?
Right here. Bullshit.
We get security here?
That is not the real Tim Heidecker. That is Joe Biden in a mask.
Wait. Come on, man.
That is Joe Biden in a mask. The real Tim Heidecker is on 38th and 8th Avenue right now taking improv classes at the Upright Citizens Brigade Theater.
Look, Jack.
Because he just got cast on Saturday Night Live. Take off the mask. Take it off.
Is that who I think it is?
Is that Jason?
Is that Jason Selvig from The Good Liars? Is that who that?
Oh, we're getting pranked. Yeah, it's me. We're getting pranked.
He's like a professional interrupter kind of.
Yeah, that's me.
This is your shtick. What do you do? I'm not Joe Biden in a mask of Tim Heidecker. I don't.
Sorry, that's my mistake.
What are you doing here, man? What's the problem? Like,
I just wanted to, you guys were doing a show. It's kind of my thing. I interrupt people. I thought maybe I'd come and interrupt you guys, but I'd love to talk for a little bit if you want to chat.
Come on up, All right, come on up. It's great to have you.
I thought you interrupt exclusively like right wing kind of stuff.
Yeah, why? I thought you were more like, you're going after people like me now? Like, what's the trajectory here for you?
Yeah, equal opportunity.
You have to sort of broaden your audience a little bit?
Yeah.
Okay, so. How's that working?
It's working out really, really great.
What's the book you brought? This is...
So Tim and I, we actually met in 2016 at the Republican National Convention.
Where I was running for office.
You were running for office. And earlier that day, I got this book. It's called The Clinton's War on Women by Roger Stone. And I went to a book signing, and I Alex Jones was there too. And I stole the book from them.
Stole it?
It was in a box like next to where they were signing it, and I just grabbed one.
That's okay.
And I asked Alex Jones to sign
Roger Stone.
Let's see, I could do a little...
You could do Alex.
Yeah, it's not
What's
great
up, man? How you doing, man?
It's not good for my voice, but I can do it for you.
Oh, yeah, don't.
Roger Stone. Stone. Roger Stone's going to be calling in later.
You got a couple more shows.
Well, Donald Trump.
Wait a minute. Now we have a rule, Vic. We can't play real Alex when I'm doing fake Alex because it reminds people that it doesn't really sound like him.
So we and
9/11 was an inside job.
Yeah. So I asked him to sign it. 9/11 was an inside job, and he did. He signed it. 9/11 was an inside job.
Absolutely. Absolutely. I'll do that 9 days a week. I'll tell you what. I'll sign it again. I'll just say 9/11 is still an inside job. It's more inside now than ever.
And then
they're finding out new stuff. There are new documents coming out, and you can look into it. You can read the FICA documents that just came out, page 33, 34. If you look into that, you actually get into the details of it, see what's been redacted, and then you can extract the redaction from that. And I'll tell you, folks, it's going to blow your brain. I tell you.
The water is making the turtles gay.
Yeah.
And then I asked Roger Stone to sign the same thing, and he said, I don't know if 9/11 was an inside job. So he signed it. I'm not sure if government did 9/11.
You're not giving that to us, though.
No, this is mine to keep. This is my book. But there is somebody that, that wants to say hi.
Okay.
My literal partner in
crime. Roger Stone.
It's Roger Stone.
Dr. Roger.
Okay, let's say hi
to
your partner.
DeVram, are you on Zoom there?
Yeah, can everyone hear me?
Oh, there
look
he is.
It is.
There he is.
Thanks, guys. I'm so bummed I couldn't make it, and I'm sorry about that. I'm at this convention that I do, you know, every year, and I just couldn't call out. So,
what hotel room is that?
I'm at some family friends in Tempe, Arizona, at the George Soros Convention for Jewish and Hollywood Elitist Global Dominance. The GSCJHEGL convention. So, yeah, just having a blast here. It's something I couldn't miss.
So you're not there to goof on them. You're there attending to get, like, points and strategy meetings and stuff?
DeVram's Jewish. He's Jewish.
A lot of trouble. Well, we play a lot of volleyball, do a lot of bonding and everything, but then we also figure out how we want to, you know, allocate all the money, all the billions of dollars to control the world.
Yeah, what do you think is the... The next, you know, 2-3 year plan that Soros is cooking up, like, what's he looking to do?
For now, we are just prank calling Marjorie Taylor Greene. The police department. We're trying to get her swatted.
Trying to get her swatted.
Oh, that was you guys. You swatted.
Yeah, we've been calling. It's like everyone has a couple of drinks, and then we start doing prank calls, and done that the last couple nights, but. You know, mostly we come here every year, and the biggest thing we're trying to do is kind of vote on who we want to be the next president of the United States. So,
what's it looking like?
Stuff.
Who's it going to be?
It's going to be Hillary Clinton.
Oh.
Yeah.
Have you not read the book?
What's that?
That's okay.
Yeah, I mean. You know, we know that she's, you know, she's addicted to adrenochrome and all that. We're trying to get her off of it, but it's hard. You come to these conventions every year, and you get hooked on it again, so.
What about Steve Harvey? He would be a good president, maybe.
He would be very, very good.
Well.
Steve Harvey, yeah, we've talked to him. We've talked to him a little bit. Have you been to the convention? How do you know that?
Cut the tape.
I don't know. I just guessed, I guess. Yeah.
I don't know what the hell he's talking about.
We have a bunch of big plans. You know, COVID was us. So.
COVID was you guys.
Yeah. If you want, you know, so COVID, there's a reason it's called COVID. Ovid means sheep in Latin.
Oh, yeah.
C is like if you see. And then 19 was like an old number in ancient times that meant surrender. So it's called sea sheep. Surrender. Uh-huh.
That's cute.
That's funny to us. Yeah.
It was in front of our eyes the whole time. If we just looked at
well,
it.
Let me ask you guys a serious question. you guys are kind of blowing up a little bit. I have like you know, you're getting into Randy Rainbow territory.
Which we're almost as big as Brooklyn Dad Defiant, which is big for us. Yeah.
So are you getting caught? Are you getting? I know you. I'm not talking to you. That's starting to happen.
It happens usually when we do stuff. It happens fast enough where they're like, it's already happened.
Right.
Whatever was going to happen happened.
Yeah.
But we did get. We were at CPAC and some people came up to us. Some guy from Ted Cruz's staff, and he was like, I know who you guys are.
Looked just like Ted Cruz.
Yeah. Like, he was bit by the same. Radioactive, whatever. and he was like, I'm a big fan of you guys. And we were like, does Ted like us? Because we've done like 4 or 5 Ted Cruz pranks to him. And he was like, no.
Oh.
Ted does not have a sense of humor, which is surprising.
No, yeah. He does a lot of like, he tweets a lot of things that are like, this is funny.
Yeah.
I got to admit, this is funny.
He wishes he was a comedian, I think. That's like his goal, I think.
I heard a story, not really a story, but from a congressman. I obviously pal around with congressmen.
Yeah, of course.
but I was talking to this congressman, and he was like, dude, there's no one that's more full of bullshit than Ted Cruz. And if you see him in the halls, He's like, hey, buddy, we're still buds, right? Like, yeah. We're, it's all, he's like, it's all just a game. Like, you get it, right? Like, I'm not, I don't really, it's like, he doesn't believe anything he says. He's a
complete malarkey.
I hope not. I mean, he's like, you know, he endorsed a guy that called his wife ugly.
Yeah.
He like, literally, like, he yeah, was, Donald Trump said that, said his dad yeah. killed JFK.
Well, that one I have
Lindsey Graham
questions
say
about.
That if someone killed him on the Senate floor, they wouldn't vote to convict?
Yeah, they were, there wouldn't Nobody be any witnesses. It. It's sad. It's actually kind of sad, to be honest.
Well, I'm Joe Biden's husband.
See you all in hell.
You can't really talk about what you're up to, I suppose.
No, we can talk about it. We're not really doing that
yeah,
much.
Yeah, what's the worst thing?
No, we're gonna be out on the road soon. Some more stuff.
Are you out. Really out there at some convention? Not, I know not the convention you were joking about, but
we were at CPAC a couple. Oh, you're talking to DeVrom. Yeah.
My parents sold their house in Grand Junction, Colorado, and now I'm back visiting them and staying in the our neighbor's house. So I wake up in the morning, I look at the house I grew up in. It's pretty. Weird.
Well, thanks for giving us the ceiling fan view. We always appreciate that on office hours. That's.
I wish it was.
You want to let that guy go for a spin? Yeah. Why don't you give that guy?
Turn it
on. Give that guy a little spin for us.
Turn it on.
Turn it on.
Turn it on.
One of the little things in life is not knowing which chord does the light and which chord did. How many people have ever gotten it right on the first pull?
Not one.
Not one.
Yeah.
That's not funny. So I mean, this is so boring. Oh my God. Do you want to head out?
Yeah. Maybe wait. Get like a bite?
There's more wireless mics in the audience? Like, Matt, no more
hell?
Wireless mics for the crowd.
What okay. the hell? Fucking sucks. Jesus Christ.
This is the most.
Wait. Sorry. He noticed us.
Hey, can you...
Oh.
What's
hey.
Going on here?
Oh, hey, man. What's
hey.
Up?
Oh, it's
hey.
Jeremy and Rajat.
How
it's
are
Jeremy
you?
And Rajat.
Hi.
I know these guys. I know these guys.
What are you guys doing? You're interrupting my show? What do you think?
I'm
you're
sorry.
The good liars?
It's... You guys haven't been funny in, like, 4 minutes. You guys are, like, doing this whole out-of-character thing. Go back to that good shit.
Wait, no, that's already been a bit that we did
Jason,
with Tim Robinson.
Go back to when Jason interrupted. That was good shit.
Sorry,
you lost your edge.
You guys don't like the ceiling fan stuff then, huh? Scratch that.
Turn it off. Turn it off.
No.
Turn it off.
Well, what?
You did it wrong.
Are you guys are, I mean, you guys are just ripping off these guys is what you're doing. Like interrupting a live show with.
We got our own
No.
On it. We're doing our own thing.
We have our what? Own flavor on it.
All right, well, come on up. Let's see All what right. it is. I don't know. Sorry.
Can I have a sniff?
Thank you.
Woo, woo.
All right, let's see what you got.
Yes, stick around, Jason, if you want, or I don't know.
Trustworthy ninja hood, right?
Nice to meet you.
So what do you want to do? I mean, how are you different than the good liars?
We're not. I don't know what to tell you.
Fucking short people.
Yeah, I don't think this is the right height.
Thank you. So what's
Okey
up?
Okey dokey.
Who's that? What is this?
That's the good liars that you're ripping off.
We do our
yeah,
own
on,
thing,
guys.
Really.
Yeah, we kind of got... What?
Yeah, so yeah. What else? You guys have sold out? What? We didn't plan this bit.
No.
No.
Let's talk about this shirt. This is the crazy, not that shirt, not Jeremy's shirt. This. Has anyone seen anything like this before?
Pretty cool, huh?
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's the band. You can clearly see that. I don't think you need the name of the band on there. It's clearly the band. It's a little redundant.
You lost
Peace
it, man.
Peace and love.
What?
You lost it.
I lost it, okay.
You lost it.
It's a piece of Ringo Starr. It's a Ringo Starr painting. You might want to.
Yeah, it's a Ringo Starr painting. It's these are the four members. You got John, Paul,
George and Ringo.
No, it's not that band. It's the band. It's Levon and...
The Beatles. This is the Beatles. Right here. And you can get it on the ring... That one, yeah. You can get it on ringostarart.com if anyone is looking
for art. Ringostart.com?
Yep.
So what else?
How have you been?
How's your summer?
Fine.
Yeah?
It's all right.
How have you been since the Joe Rogan video?
Oh, you're plugging, huh? Plugging. Everybody's plugging.
You can check it out. YouTube.com.
/ Joe Rogan video, Tim.
Do we know... people ask me that every night about that video. We do a Q&A, and they ask about how it happened, how we did it. Did we write it? And we did. There was a script. There was a 400-page script.
We were word perfect, yeah. I think, David on Chase our script.
Oh, yeah. The rehearsals were so...
Yeah, yeah. Month
wow.
of rehearsals.
Lots of rehearsals.
Up in Woodstock.
Well, we're actors, me and Rajat. I actually don't know if you've heard of the show Severance.
Yeah.
Oh, yes.
Yeah, that's right.
Oh, yeah.
Rajat has a line in it.
And thank you. No. Oh, please, yeah. please. But let's all say the line together. You guys ready?
3, 2, 1.
The neti pot is warm.
That was you?
Me,
oh,
yeah.
Shit.
I warmed the neti pot, that's right. I kind of good liar severanced in a way.
But yeah, you said we're actors, so what do you mean, Jeremy?
Have you heard of the 4% Rotten Tomatoes Comedy Central show Fairview?
No.
It's like South Park, but they look like Weebles, and I voice a character called Todd.
Oh, yeah, Todd, yeah.
You guys remember Todd Osterdorf? Yeah. Do you want to say...
Do your voice.
My line on three, the audience.
Your line.
Okay, yeah.
3, 2, 1. Beef, I'm home.
You did that?
Yeah, I don't know if you could tell, but Todd is from the South.
Oh, fun. Yeah. What a fun. Do you get to play around with that, or you just go by the lines?
It's so fun. We go by the lines, but yeah.
I mean,
but before we roll, it's all so fun.
Yeah. They're on Zoom and you're in a booth by yourself.
I'm on Zoom as well. What else?
What else Vic? We got?
Matt, where are we at with the show? Do you need to guide me in any direction?
You wanna take another Zoomer?
Yeah,
would
let's
you like
see
to
who's
all
out
interact
there.
With a Zoomer?
Let's see if we can pile
That's
up on
fun,
that.
Right?
He's
whatever.
Still there, but.
Oh, yeah, well, we'll have, you can talk to another Zoomer. Abe, what is it? Abbott Public?
Abby.
It does.
Abby?
Abby, yeah, can you hear me?
Hey, Abby.
Hey, how are you?
Hi there.
Hello.
I have 2 points.
Two points? Uh-oh.
I'm coming tonight, but I do have one VIP ticket to give away. My brother cannot come with me anymore. And
ooh.
Does
somebody here want it?
Seriously,
this guy here?
Nope.
Come here.
This is going to be a real complicated transaction.
You'll figure it out. Just give you... You're going to have to wrestle me for it. Ready?
It's a draw,
but next time. No, I'm just kidding. You got the ticket, okay? I'm so rough with you. It was rough. Are you okay? You're not hurt? I didn't get hurt. How am I going to get hurt by him? I mean, he's a good-sized guy, though. Could have gone the other way.
Definitely.
What if I really got hurt? Yeah, so you just have to stay here all day until the show starts.
Wow. I want to feel this guy's muscles.
What's your
muscles.
Name? Just Kyle. What are you, fucking Bono? Kyle Best, Pete Best's grandson is here.
Oh. Wow.
Music, Rajat, you love that.
Mm-hmm.
So Avi, can you connect with him and figure it out?
Yeah.
I get high. I get high.
I
get
on with
kids.
I had a question for Tim also.
Okay, so you're good. Just, we'll remember you.
Thank you, Ringo.
I want these seats full, you know? I don't want some dude sitting alone. Okay, so point number two.
Point number two is I'm a photographer here in the city, and I do this thing where I take Polaroids of the people I work with and some of my favorite people that I meet. I was just wondering if you'd be cool if I brought my Polaroid tonight before the show. I just got a picture of you, and you could sign it. It goes into, I've got a big Polaroid book with a lot of people I've worked with.
Show me the most famous person you...
I have Pusha T right here.
Who is it?
It's Pusha T.
Pusha T.
Rapster?
He's a rapster.
Your merch person is Pusha T when they're... You have the T.
Well, I'm going to say yes, but then play it by ear.
Yeah.
Appreciate it.
It seems like a lot to ask, you know? A picture.
You're probably going to be doing stuff before the show.
I just need like 45 minutes of your time.
So $40?
I need my $40. This is not a funny story, but I think it's a sweet story. Hmm. Should I tell it?
Thanks, Abby. We'll catch you later. Well,
thank you.
This is like kind of a, I could almost imagine this being a Prairie Home Companion story. Long ago, when I was, I used to work at this comedy club in Philadelphia, making chicken wings and nachos in the microwave for the audience. Yeah, all the comedians, it was just like a shitty comedy club on South Street. And there was this old man that would come in, old, I'm talking old, like really old. And he'd come in with this like a photo book, big photo book, like thick photo book. And this guy's thing was like this weirdo. He would take pictures with whoever was there. Like for...
This sounds like it's going to lead to something scary.
I told you it was a sweet story.
Well, I'm making it sour.
Give me some... Vic, play some piano to this. Play some beautiful Randy Newman-y kind of... Anyways, this guy would take the pictures with all the famous people. Now, what was fascinating was he's been doing it since he was like 20 years old. And so this book you see like the Frank Sinatra and all these old people, all these old art people you've never heard of. Oh, years and years go by. And the only thing that's changing is you're seeing this guy getting older and older. And he's probably fucking dead now. Think about it, dead.
That's so sweet.
Yeah.
And this was a sweet story.
I told you. And it's not even a story either.
No.
It's just a thing that I know.
Oh, he's dead.
I'll say it clear. Doug was right. I'll state my
case. And the last picture is him with Jim Brewer from 1997.
So he went Sinatra to Brewer.
Yeah. Okay. So that was a Zoomer. Anybody real in the audience that has a question? I forgot to do that.
That's a good question.
So many plants. Somebody had.
I'll say.
This guy over here. Or any ladies? No, ladies don't. They don't want to bother with this. They know it's pointless. Yes, right there. Can you maybe give her the mic?
I really wanted to hear you sing What Will We Do With Our Time at the end part where you sing Weed Whackin', Long Blowin', Snow Blowin'.
I could do that
really
for you.
I really wanted to hear that at the two shows that I went to.
Uh-huh.
So yeah, I was wondering if you could do it today.
I don't...
Just that last part where it gets really soulful.
Yeah. I mean, I could just... You want me to just do that part?
Yeah. Yeah.
Brooklyn! Oh, rim shot!
This is a bad idea, just so you know.
It's not.
I'm going to warm up into that. Let's see if I can do it. Maybe I can't.
I'm a weed whacking, lawn mowing.
What is it?
Snow shoveling.
What is it?
Leaf blowing.
Leaf blowing. Lawn mowing. Leaf blowing. Snow shoveling.
That's it.
Boy.
You're welcome. We're going to play a song with the band today, too. That's the other big treat. Any other questions out there? Yes.
No.
I see what right up front here. Did you raise your
hand? Naya.
Yep, there's one over there, too. Oh, there's plenty.
Weed whacking, snow shoveling, leaf blowing, lawn mowing. Oh, I'm a...
And then what's the noun at the end? Prick?
Prick. Boy.
Tim, do you think that Freak we episode. Are in like a vibrational superstructure, like a, in like a simulation is a vague way of saying it, but do you think we're in like a pattern?
Is that Vic? Sounds like Vic is
yeah, it's a. That's a clip from, do we have Tim Pool's new song yet?
No, it's not out yet.
Where's that coming?
Tomorrow.
Oh, we should have scheduled this.
Yeah. Oh, get the teaser, yeah. See if you can
have
get
you guys
the teaser.
Seen Tim Pool's
song? I'll look for that. I'll look for that.
Oh, got, so
you
good.
Know who his drummer is?
Who's his drummer?
The former Offspring drummer who quit the band because he didn't want to get vaccinated. So he's getting their dregs.
Whoa.
You have it?
Oh, he does. He
Wait,
does.
Let's get to the question. Then
we can... Hey, what's going on? If you could be on any game show, which game show would you want to be on?
Imagine wanting to know that.
You missed work? You like missed work to it's ask a, that question?
I am at work right now. Yeah.
It's a weekday.
Give it to me, baby.
I want to know.
I like, I don't.
Is that for Tim or for all of us?
Everybody.
Double dare.
Good answer.
Maybe just one word answers. Jeopardy.
Nerd. Price is Right.
For sure.
Next question.
Wheel.
Wheel.
Is that your answer, Wheel?
Oh, me? Oh, I gotta go millionaire. Who wants to be a millionaire? Me.
Yeah. I'd have to say, obviously, The Voice. Is that a game show? Kind of. I do these Q&As before all the shows for you know, it's a premium ticket, right, folks? Premium. People say, thank you, you're so generous for your time. Like, you're paying, I'm not doing this for free. But somebody yesterday was like, if you had to choose between doing comedy or music or acting, or what would you choose? I don't have to, so I'm not going to. Like, why would I want to do, why would I... entertain that hypothetical. Yeah, but really, but if you had to. But I don't. Next question.
Next question.
Okay, great question. That turned into a great experience for everybody. Somebody up front with the Billy Joel shirt on. Whoa.
I got past the microphone up here.
Do you guys know I banned Vic from wearing Billy Joel shirts on tour?
I have so many Billy Joel shirts and they're not allowed.
I got a question. Can I ask my question?
Yeah.
This is a question for Vic.
Oh.
Vic, thank you so much for introducing me to the Beach Boys.
Oh, hell yeah.
Oh, Vic, there's a Beach Boys parody song out there from the Babylon Bee. Did you see this?
Oh, no.
Yeah, I wish we all could leave California, is what it's called. Yeah. Seems funny. Okay, question for Vic.
My question is, Vic, what do you think is the most underrated Beach Boys album or song?
That's a very good question. I love when I watched you walk with me, tears filled my... What's that called? Let 'em Run Wild. Let Her Run Wild. But also, like, the album right before Pet Sounds, I think it's Today, the second half has all these, like introverted songs mixed with, yeah.
You're saying you're a big fan of the song Tomboy, and that's
Hey, yeah. Well,
Hey Little Tomboy? Well,
yeah, I mean, that's obviously that's the best. That's the one where...
That's a hidden gem.
That is one where he... You know, this tomboy who's in the neighborhood, he gathers the Beach Boys around and says, it's time to grow up. And he forces her to shave her legs. And the song, I swear to God, I'm like, all right, let's time to be a woman now.
That's the song that Vic likes a lot.
Hey, Little Tomboy, that's my favorite track. So, is that weird? I don't know.
But, we can't really put this out. No. Do we know about, have I talked much about the prank call to Mike Love?
You should totally do
we
it. Yeah.
Just play but it.
Just, yeah.
We
use different
you know about
names.
This? We pranked Mike Love, and we called
not,
as
not,
the
not us, but like, you want to say who?
No, it was I won't I won't dox the people that we did it with. I'm happy to do it, but we called as the it was the day before the inauguration in 2017 of Donald Trump. And we somehow got Bruce Johnston's number, who is in the Beach Boys. One of the only guy left in the
He's
Beach
Mike's
Boys.
Like right
Mike's
man.
Mike's
yeah, his sidekick.
Yeah, his little toady.
Yeah.
And we somehow got his number. And so they were going to play the inauguration, one of the balls. So we called as representatives from the Trump campaign to go over their set and give them a lot of direction. And so Bruce answers, and he doesn't know what to do. He's like, well, you better talk to Mike about all this. So he gives us Mike's number. And we get Mike on the phone. And oh my God, we had him on for 20 minutes. Well, I don't want you playing that Hey Little Tomboy song, all right? Trump don't like that one. And you make sure you wear tuxedos. And I said, Trump wants you to do the Billy Joel song,
yeah,
New York State of Mind.
Do some covers.
He's like, I don't know if we're kind of dialed in.
I don't like it.
And I don't want you to have that weirdo there, the fat one. What's his name, the piano player? He's like, no, he won't be there.
I don't like it.
We had him going, and then we're like, yeah, he's like, how's he doing anyway? How's Mr. Trump doing? You know, he's not good. He's been in the bathroom with diarrhea all day. He's in bad shape. And then, yeah, we got real deep. We're like, he loves that album, Beach Boys Love You, which is a very weird album from the 70s. Like, he loves that one from Mike Love. Didn't know what to do about that. Not one of Mike's
favorites. Kokomo!
Anyway.
You Semites.
So there's your answer. How about a Zoomer, Matt? Let's say hi to the world.
Yeah, and then should we let these guys sit down?
Oh, yeah,
just kind of standing around here.
It's good for their physique.
It's like a pageant.
Yeah, I enjoy seeing more white men on our stage, but
you can lie on the floor.
I think just stay like that. Just stand. Just keep standing.
No, I like you guys chiming in. I mean,
what are you going
to? Do you guys want them to stay?
I think we should leave it up to them.
It was a little. That wasn't a roaring.
I was trying to, politely. Yeah.
Politely get us off stage. I think maybe that's the right call. I don't know.
Get the hell off our stage.
If you want to.
No, but thank you. Yeah. Right? Anyway, Loose Sassel. Or stay, whatever. Loose Sassel, are you here?
The hell?
We'll be right back.
I think you should crouch.
Yeah.
Suck my such and such.
Don't crouch. Don't fully commit to the bit.
Yes, sir.
Who's there? Loose sauce? Loose anus?
Oh, Lou disappeared. Where'd Lou Sassel go? All right, Tabor. Sam Tabor. And then we got to bring out our other surprise guest.
Let's go.
How's it going?
Pretty good.
Hi, Sam.
Hey, Tim, I was at your show on Monday there at the Bell House. It was a ton of fun. You invited my girlfriend up on stage. She was wearing an Apple Watch.
Uh-huh.
And I wanted to apologize because I was wearing this dog mask. I thought it distracted you during your show.
No, I didn't notice it.
Okay, great. I was bugging me all week.
Nope, you're good.
You do love your dogs, don't you?
He's got the ceiling fan in the reflection of the Roger.
Yeah. Although I do need a guitar strap tonight.
Yeah.
You want to drop one off?
I'm back in Louisville already, so unfortunately not going to get there in time.
Well, I guess you can't.
Yeah.
All right.
Wait, did you say Louisville? You say Louisville?
Louisville, Kentucky.
Yeah, I was born and raised there in Louisville, Kentucky. Yeah. You don't have to clap. It's usually when you say the name of a town, people.
Louisville Slugger. Big baseball bat.
That was my backyard wrestling name.
That's was what?
Louisville Slugger. And I used to backyard wrestle.
Oh, okay.
In high school. Yeah.
Thank you.
I didn't get it. Can you talk to me about it after the show? Okay. I'll talk to you about it after the show.
I'd rather not talk about it.
Matt, is it musical guest time?
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Thanks, Sam.
That's this all I had. Thanks, guys.
Now you guys probably should clear, just for the sake of clearing the path. Not
thank you for having us.
Yeah, stick around, okay?
Yeah, yeah. Emmys.
Anything to promote?
Yeah, the Emmys are coming up September 12th. If anyone is from the Academy in the audience, vote for Rajat and
Severance.
I.
Severance.
For what?
Again.
Are you eligible for that performance?
We're doing an FYC campaign. Yeah. And
just, again, neti pot is warm. That's the line.
Really
and,
fun.
Yeah.
How was Ben as a director? A good director? Okay.
Yeah. I'll leave it at that.
Okay. Yeah. Probably didn't engage with him much, right? More into the assistant director communication line.
More of that, yeah. Well, I mean, it was a lot of me and Ben also just hashing out what's this line going to be?
Swapping stories.
You know, stories. And,
you know what? I'm not kidding you. I spoke to him about you, and he remembered you.
He did.
Yeah.
That's what you say about your your best actor. I remember
him. That's what you say. Yeah, and I'm sure Walken and Totoro and all those guys, they probably remember me, too.
There you go. Yeah.
All right.
Chris is here tonight. Chris Walken is here.
Oh, yeah.
Hey, Chris.
Hey.
How you doing? You know my Christopher Walken impression? How you doing?
Oh, my God.
How y'all doing out there?
Oh, my God.
That's really
There's
good.
Something wrong with you.
It's better than Kevin Pollak, so that's really good.
Oh, shit. I watch my Johnny Carsons, this morning, I watched this Kevin Pollak appearance. You know who Kevin Pollak is? He's like an actor. I think he's a fine impersonator. You're not impressed with his work.
He just does the main ones that
Columbo
everyone does.
Columbo and Jack Nicholson and Shatner and stuff. But this poor Kevin Pollak, he had been on a few times, I guess, so Johnny knew him and stuff. But he comes out, and it must have been around Halloween, but he comes out dressed as Cupid. With this like pink sash and the wings, and it does not work. The joke is that he didn't know that nobody else was going to be wearing costumes. That was the bit, but they couldn't get over it. Like he was so you could see him just like adjusting it the whole time, and Johnny's just like making fun of him, and just it was brutal. He's just like, I guess I'm gonna have to talk to my manager about this. Oops. There you go. All right. Well, clear the path.
Yeah, thanks.
For our big, big musical guest. This guy is a legend. This guy is a legend, one of the greats. I'm not even gonna say anymore, Mr. Loudon Wainwright is coming out, folks. Mr. Loudon Wainwright. Mr. Wainwright?
Yes.
thank you for being here. How about this? Why don't we get a song from you?
Okay.
And then we'll take that song, put it in the bank, and then speak for a moment.
That sounds great.
Okay, take it away.
All right. How you doing? I guess I can use this microphone. Is this good? It better be. I need a family vacation. I mean a family vacation alone. I'm gonna pack up the car, load up the bike and the kayak, and leave the fucking family at home. A vacation away from the family. A vacation away from the fray. When it comes to your so-called loved ones, sometimes you got to get away. Maybe I'll go to the mountains, or else I'll get down to the shore. Yeah, and I guess there's a chance I might miss my people, but right now I can't stand them no more. When I'm barbecuing there on my Weber, I might be focused on my family. Then I'll throw down some hot dogs, burgers, and some chicken. I'll burn them all in effigy. When I get back from my family vacation, tanned and relaxed will be the shape that I'm in. Yeah, I'll be patient and loving, not to mention detached, when I'm dealing with my kith and my kin. We all need a family vacation. You got to keep the mishpoka at bay. Tolstoy got it right when he wrote, each unhappy family is unhappy in its own way. I ran away from my parents. I still run away from my kids. As for brother and sister, we're playing Twister. It's a cover-up to keep ourselves hid from each other. I need a family vacation. My family needs a vacation from me. Because your dearest and nearest, they're the most dangerous. They're the ones that make ya crazy. That's right, your dearest and nearest, they're the most dangerous. They're the ones that make you fucking crazy. Oh. Jean-Paul Sartre said it. Hell is other people.
Thank you very much.
Wow. This guy's not standing. No. Oh, sorry. Maybe you can't.
Thank you very much.
I had to ask for it. I had to ask for the standing O. You just get it.
Well, I'm glad everybody out there is in some family or other so they know what I'm talking about.
I hear it. I feel it. I hate my kids. No.
That's why you're a great dad.
Yeah. You've got kids.
Oh, boy. Don't get me started on my kids.
No. That was beautiful. You're a legend. And the fact that you're here is stupid, but awesome. I mean, great. So thank you. What do you want to talk about? Do you want to talk about your? You have this weird distinction of being the first sidekick to David Letterman.
We were talking about that earlier.
And you don't have to talk about it if you don't.
No, I can talk about it. She wants me to talk about it. You may recall, some of you older folk might recall that the original incarnation of the David Letterman show was a morning show.
Yeah.
It was...
after the Today Show or something?
Something like that. And I was hired to be the... they conceived of a situation where they would have a musical kind of sidekick, Ed McMahon guitar playing, pithy remarks... So for the whole first week, I was on the Letterman morning show, and then they
How'd
said,
that go?
"Well, this isn't working." They said, "Do you have Paul Schaefer's number?" I don't know, but it was fun to do it. And but yeah, I was also. Did you know that I was also an original member of Spinal Tap?
What, really? Tell me about that. I have no idea.
This is more factual than humorous, but the original... I went to college with Michael McKean, and Chris Guest and I have been friends for a long, long time.
Nice.
So Rob Reiner did a TV special. Again, this is way, way back in the early 70s, called The TV Show. Chris was in it, and Michael was in it, and Marty Mull and Harry...
It's a great title.
The TV show.
I could bring that back, right? We could do a show called The TV Show.
So
or not. Fuck you.
So there were sketches and all kind of interesting, funny things, but they had an idea of doing a hard rock band with Rob Reiner kind of playing a Wolfman Jack kind of character.
Midnight special.
Yeah, exactly. So the first... Spinal Tap thing was on this TV show, and I was the keyboard player. And if you can see me on YouTube, she saw me on YouTube. That's why she wanted me to talk about it.
Your and, daughter's here, apparently. I guess.
My agent, who was also my daughter, but you know,
he's out, he's done. He's like, fuck this. I don't want to hear it from no Spinal Tap keyboard player. Got fired.
He wants more folk music.
Yeah.
Anyway, that's another groovy factoid from my swinging life.
He got replaced by Viv from the movie. Is it Viv? He has the best line in that movie, the keyboard player. It could have been yours. He said, did you do a fake British accent?
No,
we didn't really speak.
No,
right?
I didn't really speak.
At the end, they go, what's your advice? What's the words to live by? He goes, have a good time all the time. That's my philosophy, Marty.
Why?
I could have said that. I don't know why.
So you got a new record?
Got a new record. It's called Lifetime Achievement. That song, Family Vacation, is also on it.
Oh, that's a new one. Nice.
Oh, yeah, brand new.
Bold. Come out with the new stuff. Boom.
Right. I'm playing in New York next Tuesday night at the City Winery.
Hey-o. Those tickets are now officially sold out thanks to this crowd.
And then there's the...
You were living in England for a while?
Yes, I lived in England for 17 years.
Did you know? I mean, this is... I'm not very good at this, you know?
They used to call me Loudon Wainwright III.
Oh, well, that makes sense. Wait, you know what's funny? I was thinking... I don't know if you... Well, you don't. There's no way you would know this. If you knew this, it'd be weird. Vic Berger here is Vic Berger IV.
Yeah. Wow.
What?
Yes. No middle name.
Shame on you for not naming Rufus... Loudon, because then we'd have Loudon, Wainwright. Wait, why did you drop it? Why did you let go of the tradition?
three strikes and you're out. I'm sure Rufus is very happy that. He's not.
It's a confused. You get people have trouble with the name all the time.
Yeah, it's a tricky name.
There you go, folks. That's the truth. Anybody have any questions for Loudon that I don't have? I mean,
we have a long distance question specifically here. Ryland, are you there on Zoom, Ryland?
This is crazy technology, isn't it? Pretty neat.
Yeah, isn't that neat?
See this guy?
Yeah.
This is my close buddy.
Hello, Ryland. How's it going?
Ryland Bojack. We went to Berkeley together, room together.
Hey, Vic, how's it going,
What's
man?
What's up, Ryland?
How you doing?
So good. Well, I wanted to say hello. I wanted to tell you something. My wife and I, when we first got together, we were buying records, and we found a whole bunch of your early records, and we really, when we were just getting together and just spending a lot of time, we listened to your stuff all the time.
You're fucking to his music, are you?
Say that again.
You're fucking to his music.
Well, you know, I don't want to say
it's good love much, making music. I've done it. It's
come on, man. This is my fan.
Sorry.
I'm sorry, Ryan.
Sorry.
We listen to it all the time, and my name is Ryland, actually, and my dad named me after the musician Ry Cooter, who we're also big fans of. So when we finally had a son years later, we're like, wouldn't it be cool to name him Loudon? And so we did. We named our son Loudon after you, our big fans, and just want to tell you how much we appreciate you and just how much just your songs have just been a part of our lives.
Wow, Ryland, I that's beautiful. I think you might owe me some money, though.
Yeah.
That's a copywritten.
I thought it would be funny. I said, you know, it's funny to tell you like this. I thought it would be maybe one of the most awkward situations in the world if we were to bring our young child to one of your shows and hold up and say, this is, here it is. This is Loudon.
It's Loudon here. It's Loudon here.
That's great. I love that. Thank you.
It's a little too loud in here for the baby. How about that?
Appreciate everything you've done.
Thank you very much.
Wow, that's sweet.
Ryland.
Sweet show tonight.
You know when they start naming their kids after you, you know.
It's time for you to shuffle off.
Yeah, it means you're almost dead. I mean, legendary.
You're spry, though.
Well, yeah.
I like that.
I took a lot of a leave, so I'm feeling okay.
Here's a question. In your mind, do you have a song of yours that you would define as changed your life in some significant way?
So many incredible songs. Well, you know, since we're talking about shuffling off and getting old and shit, in the first paragraph of my obituary, undoubtedly Dead Skunk in the Middle of the Road. Well, are you guys too young to have heard Dead Skunk in the Middle of the Road?
They are.
Wow, that's great.
But they're
going to
be polite about it. They're going to be, why don't you just applaud like you fucking care, like you know. It's all a big show.
I want to tell you, this song was in 1972. It was number one in Little Rock, Arkansas. Really? For 6 consecutive weeks?
Jesus.
So I always had a fantasy that Bill and Hillary were
making love to them.
Right, fooling around in the back of the Rambler. Dead skunk in the middle of the road. Dead skunk in the middle of the road. Dead skunk in the middle of the road. Stank in the high heaven. We should be doing this and not the Dylan song.
Well, we're not.
Okay.
Sure smells good.
And then you kind of blew up in England.
I blew up?
You blew up, like when there's an IRA bomb in the... No. You were very successful in England.
Oh, yeah. I'm a massive star in England.
Yeah. How did that happen?
We were talking about that earlier.
I know. You know what? I never do this before, because I've never met you before. But you immediately were very approachable and friendly and...
I told all my people to stay home.
Wonderful backstage vibe. But we just started talking, not like you're supposed to do, like you're human beings.
Friendly person who just wants to laugh and have fun.
And I was asking you just natural questions, but then I realized I was actually doing the pre-interview with you.
Yeah.
I wasn't being strategic about it. I wasn't trying to be cute, but I am cute. just got my hair cut.
Can I show off something quick? Or are you in the middle of a thought?
What are you going to show
off?
Oh,
I was going to say, like, I wore this shirt.
Oh, MASH, yeah.
Oh! MASH. Also, in that obituary, the fact that I was in MASH, the television show.
Yeah.
Second season, original cast. Yes, Alan Alda is a very nice person.
Yeah. But you didn't do the song isn't yours.
If only. No, that was written by Johnny Mandel.
Right. Now I've lost my question.
But you were the singing soldier.
I was Captain Calvin Spaulding, the singing surgeon.
How about those MASH residual checks, huh? They just got to be coming in every day.
Well, they're
dwindling.
They're dwindling. Well, at one time they were pretty good.
MASH is on. There's got to be a MASH channel now.
We could watch MASH right now.
Yeah. We should do that. We should put MASH on. See if we could find it. I bet it's on right now. What was I going to say? Oh, yeah. So England, you, like, how do you become big in England? Like, what do I got
to
do?
When I started out, what happened to me was it was just good fortune. I made this record in 1969 called Loudon Wainwright III. And
clever.
She bought it. And it was a very strange thing to do at the time because it was just a voice and guitar, and there was no band, or I had short hair and wasn't wearing bell-bottom pants. And,
right.
But a very influential English disc jockey for BBC Radio 1 called John Peel.
You big John Peel fan. Well,
yeah, you know, this guy was the huge, massive, you know, he was bigger than Murray the K or anything. Right. Like. He was a huge, important person, and he loved my record, and he played the shit out of it. And then I was had a lot of people
that
come
was
to
it.
See me. Yeah.
They listened back when they used to listen to people with their opinions.
Yeah.
Now people's opinions aren't given any. There's no influence. Well, there are influencers. They're just awful people. Yeah. What are you? You on Twitter? You on TikTok? You on?
I'm on neither of those. Nice.
Oh, you got to get on TikTok.
I can't.
You got to.
I just.
I tried recently because somebody said you should do it, and I tried, and I just hate it. It's awful. It's an awful place. It's hell. It's hell.
But you're on it.
I'm on it, but it's barren. It's as barren as, oh boy, I don't know who. Barren as Barron Trump.
Oh.
My butt's been wiped.
What?
My butt's been wiped.
My boss can wipe?
My butt's been wiped.
No, my mic, it's John Jr. Oh.
You know, all right. John Peel, his brother did a comedy show on BBC.
Is that right?
Yeah, his brother, Banana.
Oh my God.
It's not funny.
Comedy hits keep rolling here.
That's not fair, but. all right. Matt, I'm going to go to my Morty Dakota. What's his name? Freddie Dakova. What are we doing? What's the plan now?
Why don't we talk to some more? Why don't we let Loudon rest up?
Loudon, go take a. I know you need your rest.
I'm going to go take some more leave. Thanks, folks.
He'll be back, though. He'll be back. What if I just see him, like, heading for the door now? Guitar in hand. No, we got his guitar. He's trapped. Stay. He can't
he's
go nowhere.
That's a bit of a spoiler alert. He'll come back. He'll come back for an encore.
Yeah, we're doing a little bit of a last waltz thing here with the band. The very good band is coming out in a few minutes.
But first, Loose Assel.
Oh, great.
Yay!
We're going to try
What's
again
up,
with
guys?
Loose
Hey, Loose.
Hi. How you guys doing?
Oh, we're hanging in there. I'm getting hungry for lunch.
Just,
how do you East Coasters
that.
Do it? How do you do it? I mean, are you eating usually when you're watching Office Hours? You gotta be. It's gotta be hitting right at lunch. I love lunch. We are in a little heaven bubble of New York. This has been the best week. We are staying, I won't say where, but you could probably figure it out. This is not like a ton of options. A few blocks away. And we're walking one block to Fifth Avenue in Park Slope here. I mean, it's like Disneyland Brooklyn, right? There's the bagel spot. No, Bagel World. And then Joe's Pizza. And then there's this little Italian restaurant and a bodega. It's like all you need. This Colombian restaurant we went to. Vic refused to go.
Yeah, I didn't want to go. I needed my tots instead.
He had to eat tater tots.
If they had tater tots,
there's a gelato place. I mean, it's just heaven. I like it here. Probably gonna move back.
Brooklyn!
All right, Luce, what do you have for me?
I got a question for you guys. I was wondering if you could help me generate some like abstract playlist themes. I play this game where you play with strangers and you submit songs, say like if the theme was a playlist for when you're packing up your house and moving. And a bunch of people submit a bunch of different songs. And it's really fun. And I'm an admin.
Okay, I mean, so says you.
It is fun, I promise you. I would like to send some office hours people a link and we could play together, because it's even better when you don't have like songs that you always hear. It's a good way to figure out new music.
Yeah.
So I was wondering if you could toss me some playlist ideas.
Okay. Doug?
Like,
Doug did not listen to any of that.
Sure, I did.
Oh, no.
I do like this idea. I don't know. So, waiting in line at Target? That's something you could put
on. Why are
you
waiting in line at Target? Just go right through that self-checkout. You're done.
No, I went to the one here, and there was a long line.
Cool.
But it's only probably one song worth of music.
Okay, so that doesn't work.
It's just off top. I don't know.
Yeah, it does work.
How about digging up a grave?
Okay, because
that'll take a while.
We could do Frankenstein by Edgar Winter.
See, there you go.
Right, see, you're getting it. Now you're getting it.
No.
How about Shopping for Cowboy Hats?
That's
okay, love. Yeah. This is great. I need two more.
Anybody from the audience have one? Talking to Spectrum.
Talking to Spectrum.
Toilet time.
Oh,
too.
No.
Toilet. Preparing for a colonoscopy.
Wow. That's when you're chugging the barium, right?
Ugh. All right.
But the harder and more abstract, the better, because then you get some real.
This is, listen. This is some UCB shit here. I want to move on.
Oh, fine. I usually have good conversations with you guys.
You do.
You know,
no,
you
do.
You
I'm just.
Can't win them all.
Hey. Let's cool out. Everybody cool out. Peace and love. What are you growing there?
So much shit. I'm hot as a goddamn. You can probably see my pit stains, but I'm in a greenhouse. It's hot as hell in Asheville. I'm growing azaleas. A bunch of ornamental shrubs, ferns, grasses, stuff that you put in your landscape.
Great.
Yeah.
This is the only matinee show in New York with gardening, live gardening happening.
Oh, hey, you know, through this game, somebody submitted, we were like doing a butt rock theme, and the band Hinder came up. And the song was so bad that I had to watch the music video. And the guy in the video looks just like Axiom.
Oh. Mm. Oh, wait.
Like, exactly.
I want to find, sorry, this might take a second, but could you find that Instagram from, well, first of all, the Deep Purple situation.
Oh, yeah, Joey Lynn Taylor.
Can we get that up?
Get that.
What's his name again?
Joey Lynn Taylor.
So yeah. Joey Lynn Taylor, this is the funniest video. He comes out and says,
"Well, just let him.
Yeah,
just, you gotta. Just,
it'll take a sec.
Like also like
Turner.
This will be worth
Joey
it.
Joey Lynn Turner.
Yeah, it kept getting fed to me. Like, and I was like, all right, I'll just follow this guy. I didn't know who he was, but he has this good look, you know.
Is he an original member of Deep Purple?
I don't know.
He's the singer, I believe.
No, I think he's a guitarist. I think I don't know.
No,
he's
in
Deep Purple
sure.
at some point, but now. He's on the web now. He's on social media.
He has a big
announcement coming.
There's a big
it's
which might be ready by now.
Oh, that's true.
Yeah, but
I don't
want to
see the. I want to see.
No,
the
we
one.
Don't want to know what the announcement is yet. So
you know these people that do these pre-announcements. Hey everybody, stick around. Next week we're going to be making a big announcement. Like what?
You got it?
No, sorry.
Okay, great. Let's take a question from the audience. It's been a little bit. Yes, the two ladies who were at my show last night, get up here. Get up here. Slowly get up here. People take so long to do things. Ambling up. These two. Look at you two. Look at the microphone. So I brought them up because these two ladies were sitting right there, third row, singing along to everything. Yeah. That was very, that makes me feel good. So thank you for that.
Thank you.
Did you have a question?
Yeah. We did. We're curious, we're jointly curious what your plans are to see The Billy Crystal musical.
Mr. Saturday Night.
Yeah.
But so, the plans are.
Yeah.
Like where?
We want to like
obstructed view.
Yeah. What you're wearing.
Wasn't it a flop? Did it close?
Says.
It's still
has
out
anyone
there?
Else seen it? Because we don't know how to prep for this. Or if we don't have tickets, but should we?
Go to TKTS and it'll be $25.
Okay.
Right. Well, thanks for coming up.
Good morning, everybody.
See you there. See you all there.
See you later.
Rough crowd.
It's okay. Check in with Mr. Turner.
Oh, yeah, okay, here it is, folks. The big, big announcement.
Okay, here we go.
Start it over.
Instagram doesn't let you rewind. Bear with me.
Colleen Turner, I hope you're all well and having a great summer. Haven't updated you in a while with any news or information, but next week, something extremely exciting will be announced. A new sound, a new style, and a new image coming your way.
Wow.
Better get ready, because it's going to be a hell of a ride. So buckle up, come on back, and check this out.
I got to know. I want to know what the new style and the new image is now.
New image. Matt, do we have any updates?
What if he's bald and he, like, you know, he's just, like, naked and bald?
Or they're like a barbershop quartet.
Right.
It's Jolene Turner.
Do we have an update?
It's new face.
By cameo. Here, fulfill your wishes.
Oh, you missed it. That was it. Hold on.
Oh, I did know. I do know what this is. It's not a very big
announcement. Is this the
announcement?
Is this it?
This is it.
One?
Okay.
I got to time it, though. Here we go.
And I've been invited by Cameo to fulfill your wishes. I've had many requests for me to join this platform, an amazing platform, I might add, because I believe in what they're doing. It's your chance.
That's big news. He's on Cameo now.
To intercede with a message for whoever or whatever you want. It could be for you. It could be for your loved one. It could be for a friend or somebody you hate. It could be anybody. I do bar mitzvahs, weddings, breakups especially. I'm really good with the girls, guys. If you had an argument with your girlfriend, I'll intercede. I'll play your lawyer. I'll plead your case. Whatever you need me to do, you let me know the situation, I'm there, okay? So I'm on Cameo now, so let it roll. Let's do this rock and roll style. I'm here to help. All right?
Let's hear it for Jolene Turner.
Hey.
It's certainly a new image. That's not the Deep Purple I know.
Whole new style.
And then, so the reason I brought this up, I think, is because there's another video where there's a guy in Deep Purple now that I think is Manuel from Dakar. I can't figure out if, I mean, I haven't asked him, but it feels like it is. See if you guys agree.
It's deep in the thread. Sorry, give me a second.
Oh, it's not on his page?
It's somewhere in there, but it's deep. I went deep.
We'll be right back.
Here it is.
Nice work. Now watch this, folks.
Here it is.
Oh my gosh.
Wow.
Do we know what he says there? Freedom rock?
Sweden something?
I like Sweden? Sweden rock.
Sweden rock.
We always do this. What does he say? We're good.
We know what we're doing.
Thanks. Yeah, good.
Just filling the air.
Good pep talk, coach. We always do this.
We're pretty good.
We know what we're doing.
It's a good song.
Let's just fucking get through it.
Tim, I looked him up. It looks like he left Deep Purple in 1992. Anyways, he joined in 1991 or something. He's barely.
So who is he?
Why?
I mean, he was in some other bands. I don't know, man. He was in a band called Rainbow.
Oh, Rainbow. Yeah.
Any Rainbow heads out there?
That's with is it Richie Blackmore, I think.
Should we bring the band out?
Sure.
Yeah. All right, let's bring out the very good band, and we'll start rocking. There they are. They're coming through the main gates. Maybe we can move this table. Let's just do some introductions here. We got Catfish Connor Gallagher. He's been destroying every night. Eliana Athade on the bass. Andres Velabuena. From Queens, New York. And Victor Berger IV on the keyboards. Now, let me just talk to Ellie for a second. Ellie.
Why?
You said to me the other day, a couple days ago, what did you say? Oh. About this show.
I watched my first episode of Office Hours last week. In between our bus tour and this run, because I was sad and I missed my friends. Yeah. And I loved it. It's so good.
Wow. So we got a new Office Hours head here. All right, we're going to play one of my songs. We're going to play a song called Buddy. Thank you. Would you like another one? We're going to do another one from the new record that's right at the end of the record called Kern River. This band, huh? All right, for our last song, we're gonna bring back Loudon Wainwright out here. Wainwright, if he's still here, I hope so. Otherwise, I get a new guitar. There we go.
How's everybody doing?
That's what happens when you let other people play your guitar.
Well, I play hard. I play hard, Mr. Wainwright. I'm sorry about that. I play hard.
Right? What are you from, Juilliard? Close enough for folks.
So this is a song by Mr. Bob Dylan. Everybody for coming out. I'll see you guys tonight. If anybody's coming tonight, make sure you hook up with your friend up there. And thanks again. Have a great afternoon. We'll see you soon. Bye, everybody.